slow moving.
What?
Inattentive.
What?
Dull.
What?
Shows a lack of motivation.
What?
Constantly snacking.
This is funny because he's fat.
We all saw it with our own eyes. Damn, Barkley Donaldson, I'm telling you, he jumped us.
Sure did.
I mean, gloves off, stick down, no warning. He challenged the Chiefs.
Call his name.
Call his name! Dave was
the killer. Dave's the killer.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dave's the killer.
Yes. Okay, but Dave's out. Who's going to take his place?
Is the answer Jesus?
Bro, look at yourself. You're an unemployed drunk. You play softball in corduroys. And you still live with your mother.
You shave your body hair, wear Speedos down the shore, and root for the Dallas Cowboys.
Hey, that's America's team.
Not in Jersey. We grew up 15 minutes from Giant Stadium. You're a Cowboys fan?
You're just jealous.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
Cordarrelle Patterson motions to the backfield, toss to Cordarrelle, turns up the field to the 40, to the 50, to the Rams 40 angle, to the left of the 30, shakes a tackle at the 25, Cordarrelle Patterson back to the right, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown! Yes!
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Then we'll catch him in the act.
I love catching people in the act.
Mm.
That's why I always whip open doors.
Me too.
Get to the chopper!
You play to win the game.
Playoffs? What are you talking about? Playoffs? You kidding me? Playoffs? I just hope we can win a game.
Let's go, Hanson. Come on. Not too fat, Jesus. Slide it on back. You, pretty boy.
Sweet mother of God, what is the holdup?
Son, your ego is writing checks your body can't cash.
It's only able to regroup, then it's poked away by Burke, who takes over. Pushes it up ahead to McGregor. Holy Cross coming down with a 3-on-2. McGregor from the right side, centering deep.
All right, welcome to the Beer Belly Sports Podcast, live from Fozzie Smoke and Barbecue on WBLZ. And we're starting out our day. We've got Geoffrey on the controls. And Geoffrey, I do want to say this. I know it was an accident, and I know that you weren't necessarily like trying to make like a joke out of what our intro last week, but it was so funny that you left our mic check in.
My bad.
No, dude, seriously, that was hilarious. So.
Yeah.
Hopefully we have some more happy accidents going on today.
Maybe.
Like I said, that's Geoffrey. My name's Steve O. We're on the WBLZ Network from Fozzie Smoke and Barbecue. And it's a good day to be in the barbecue business. The air is rich and thick with the smoke.
Just how we like them, right?
Oh, hey, Cainer.
Yeah, welcome.
Welcome to the
show. Hey, guys, I made it.
Way to get here on time.
Oh, don't get me started about the person I was following on the way here.
I think they
thought the speed limit was 20 miles per hour.
Dude,
so.
When we were pulling up, we saw arguably the drunkest person ever two people trying to get out of a parking spot and then drive home. So, PD, be on your guard. It was so funny. It took like 15 minutes for him to pull out of the spot.
Oh, God. Well, everyone out there, be careful.
Yeah. Anyways, it's Thursday, and that means that we have our first football game of the year, or the week, rather.
Year, close.
Right? Idiot.
Going
on right now, the color rush going on with the L.A. Rams taking on the San Francisco 49ers.
Niners.
And I think the greatest call in the history of color commentating happened earlier this game.
What was it?
Brian Hoyer ran for a touchdown, quarterback for the 49ers,
okay.
And he spiked the ball. And Chris Collinsworth goes, and I think that spike to the ground of the celebration of the touchdown might be the best pass we see from Brian Hoyer all day. And I never laughed so
hard.
He's
giving it to him.
That's brutal, man. Fucking brutal.
And they're losing, so.
So
yeah.
Is that.
And Todd Gurley, my guy, he's on my fantasy team, just scored a touchdown, so Whoop, whoop.
Way to go, Steve.
Doing all right.
Yeah, how about another?
Let's recap our fantasy week. The Beer Belly Sports fantasy team. I think we're all doing pretty okay, right?
Oh, I lost.
Man, did I squeak out a win there?
Yeah,
did you?
Oh. The Caner family pulled out over the Geoffrey Homer family.
Oh,
well, I guess I Geoffrey Homer still until
forever.
Oh yeah, I'll just go Geoffrey.
Yeah, that was quite the.
Because you played him or
no, I was playing Brittany.
You were playing his fiance, and you were playing his wife.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you both lost.
No,
the Geoffrey family lost.
The Cain family won.
That's what I mean. Like they beat you twice.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Yes. And that really sucked because I was ahead most of the week or weekend. And somehow she pulled it off.
Wow.
The thing is about the fantasy football is that you don't get most of the win.
Ooh.
You just get none of it.
Oh, I love it. The shots are fired already.
Man, am I ever grateful for that Tom Brady guy. Wow, did he have a week.
Last week, the guy's never going to throw a touchdown again. And then this week, he has the greatest game.
He's my favorite quarterback.
So happy I have him.
Oh, wow.
Well, Dez did nothing. I mean,
Dez, according to, who's that? Douchebag Skip Bayless. he says that
who's
he's
that guy.
He's not the receiver that he once was. He lost a step.
Dumbass.
So
damn.
You're fucked, man.
I know.
Yeah, Tom Brady with 3 touchdowns in the first quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Playing for Bella Cheat.
Bella Cheat.
They came out with a brand new game plan and just brought it to him.
They were pissed.
I'm excited because happened into the Patriots defense. I don't know who dropped them.
I don't know why you.
Oh, you picked them up.
Did you drop him?
No, I didn't pick. I didn't drop him.
No, I was going to say, because whoever that was.
we were assuming it was you.
You're dumb.
Idiot alert.
Nerd.
Not even a nerd. You're just a
dumbass.
Dumb.
Yeah, so Brady got 30.8
dumbass.
Points. That's pretty good, right?
That's pretty good, yeah.
Who did have the Patriots?
It doesn't matter. Whoever it was an idiot. And
I don't think no one had them.
I currently need the LA Rams defense to stop doing so well. So that's what I'm.
Well,
so,
man, the scoring starts out that they give defense a couple points.
Yeah, they give them 20 right away, and then you lose it as you
but
go.
But they also have an interception and fumble recovery.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I am going up against your former roommate.
Ooh.
OJ, oops. Don't worry, that does not play during the thing.
Yeah, I noticed that. I was like, it sounds like we're just talking like a bunch of idiots.
Well, I'm going to let that play then.
So, yeah, man, I'm just looking at my other game. I have Todd Gurley playing. He has 30 points or 18 points already, so I'm murdering.
Do you guys know who Victoria's Secret is?
I think it's my best man's wife.
Ryland?
My best Ryland? Friend's Ryland. Wife.
Yeah, it's Callie Ryland, my best okay. Best man's wife.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Well, she's going down.
She's not listening. She's going to get beat.
Real bad.
Yeah.
So,
football.
Oh, who am I?
Football.
Touchdowns.
I'm playing
balls.
Just here for the beer. Who's that?
Let me see.
Isn't that the guy that won?
Beer.
That he won that first competition, didn't he?
I don't know. Oh, yeah. One of our first. I don't remember what the hell we did.
We had to deliver Frizzle? A case of beer out to
no, that's
is that Miss Frizzle?
Miss Frizzell?
No, Walter Frizzell. It's not that Frizzell.
Not my Miss
Frizzell. Come on, the magic school bus.
Have you seen their rebooting
yeah,
that?
Yeah, that's awesome.
And someone took a picture of it and goes, not my Miss Frizzle.
Yeah, she's younger now. Isn't it like a...
She's hotter?
Some relative hotter? Of the old
it's a cartoon, bro.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Hey, there's hot cartoons out there.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah,
well,
there
I think we just learned something about you two.
Have you not seen Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
Fact.
Wow.
There
okay.
you go.
That's a real person, though.
It's a cartoon.
Oh, anyways.
Don't worry about it.
So our fantasy recap, I'm 2-0 on the season, and I have no idea how.
I'm 1-1.
I think I won by like 1.8 points last week.
There you go. who was bringing it for you?
Who is bringing it? No one. Like I got just like consistently. 10 points from like 9 people.
Oh, well, yeah. That's what you need, a well-balanced
offense. My opponent this week, Brett, is
Todd Gurley. Really was like the kicker from the Patriots. He was like my best player.
Yeah. Well, once again, my kicker was my second best player, getting 14 points.
Nice.
The Falcons kicker.
Oh, God, I hated that game.
Went
to B-dubs, and then M you guys Bryant? Wanted to go. You could have, like rubbed it in my face, but no.
I'm sorry.
I was at work.
I just got B-dubs.
Yeah, it's whatever, man.
Yeah, was that an accident or?
No, it was already planned.
So you planned to skip out on Steve-O's
I already have this planned out. Before.
I feel like you're just trying to do these things to hurt me. Why do you want to hurt me?
I mean, it's like, hello.
I'm sorry.
Do you really want to hurt me?
No.
Do you really want to see me cry?
Okay. Did you eat a lot of paint chips when you were a kid?
Maybe.
Why? anyways, enough about fantasy. What are we talking about today?
We have a whole bunch of NFL crap we got to talk about within a short time frame. Let's see. Are full-time refs really, you know, needed in the NFL?
What do you want, robot refs?
Well, we'll talk about that.
Okay.
Are full-time refs in the NFL needed? We will recap the NFC North. Should Zeke Elliott be suspended?
Yes.
What's better, NFL or NCAA tailgating?
Oh,
NHL is in 2 weeks from now. We're going to give our pre look at the NHL.
Is that the look that we do before we look?
Yes.
Okay.
It's more just like taking a shot in the dark and like hope for the best.
Just a shot in the dark.
Maybe the Sharks will go ahead and win some.
Oh, yeah, hopefully. Let's go San Jose.
You can't say that.
Yeah. You can't say that. Yeah,
that's my other team, though.
You can't say that.
So who's your number one?
Toronto, there you obviously. Go. I'm a lifelong fan of Toronto.
Clearly,
everyone
says,
knows
so shocked.
Well, okay. First off, it's fun to say.
It is.
And it's just like that. I mean, why do you gotta like front on me? And like, just because I have wavering NHL support,
I'm just trying to keep you in check. Sometimes we need that. Sometimes our faith gets distorted.
Oh.
And I'm here to bring you back to the light.
You know what? Thank God for Matt Cain.
Yeah, I guess.
Matt Cain. Wow. I don't even know what the fuck is going on anymore.
I don't know either. We're dumb.
Matt Cain?
Yeah, I was like.
Oh, yeah. Hey, speaking of that.
That's
me.
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah, it's you should bring mine, by the way.
Okay. Oh, God. Yeah, it's hanging up. And we do it. What he's talking about is we have press credentials somehow. For Bemidji State University athletics on
Hell
campus.
Yeah,
stuff.
We do.
I don't know if we got stuff for hockey. Did we get it's hockey stuff or no?
Not that I know. I think it's mine. One of these, it's in this court area.
I love
area.
That song.
It's found it.
It's me. It's me. Oh.
Is it? It's somebody's.
Sorry.
Anyways.
I just totally blanked on everything. Did we get passes for hockey or just for the hockey stuff?
I think we'll get them for everything.
Okay, cool. So we are accredited?
Hell yeah.
I don't know how.
So we get to go to, like, the media places now?
Yeah, we can go anywhere with them.
Which is...
Does this mean, like, the press conferences and stuff after the game?
Yeah.
I'm going to be...
you can go to media
Hey, Strutzy. You still good at beer darts?
You suck!
Like, yeah, you can go to media day now, which is crazy.
Yeah. That's so funny.
So we are
going to be total professionals, right, guys?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we are going to be professionals.
Well, I got mine for my work. So
you have to be.
I have to be.
We kind of have a little more leash.
Woo, woo.
We kick ass.
Whatever.
You're welcome.
I don't need this.
Damn,
God, you guys are...
I got to quit moving my head around.
All right. It's homecoming weekend, though. So are you guys? You guys going to be coming out? I know you are.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be hitting it hard.
Yeah, and so am I. Are you coming to the tailgate party?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
I have work and football to coach.
So. Awesome. So we talked about the tailgating, you know, at BSU. It's pretty all right. Let's just move into that point about which is better tailgating, NFL or NCAA. And I feel like we're going to have different viewpoints.
What do you guys got to say?
I've been to a couple Viking tailgating. I'm trying to burp and it's not coming out.
Yeah.
And I've been in a couple of Vikings games, and I've been to a couple Gopher games. Been to one BSU, shockingly, in one BSU game.
Really?
One?
That's it?
I know. I suck.
You do suck.
So what you're saying is I should probably go more.
Yeah, you should go.
What time
tomorrow?
Is pregating?
The tailgating tomorrow starts at noon.
I can get up by then.
Right? If you're willing to get up at the crack of noon every single day, then you can be a rock star.
You mean Saturday, not noon, not Friday?
I was quoting a movie. I apologize for that.
Got
it. Yeah, not unless you want to work 40 hours a week.
Right? Loser.
Son of a bee sting. It's you.
It's not. It's that bee that's buzzing around.
There's a fly around here. It's about to die.
Got time for that.
I just watched this thing about the fly episode of Breaking Bad. How annoying it was.
That is super. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That would drive me nuts, too. You get all paranoid about it, and it's not even in there. Anyways.
What?
Anyways.
The fly wasn't really in there. He just got paranoid.
I get it.
It was a literary device. Okay. We're talking about tailgating, though.
Yes.
I've been to a lot of NCAA events. I've only been to one Division I tailgate.
Where and when?
And that was in Madison.
Okay.
And it was over Halloween. Yeah. They played Penn State.
What'd you dress up as?
I didn't. Oh, no, it wasn't Halloween. It was a couple weeks before Halloween.
Okay.
And they played Penn State, and I think there was enough people running around with Jerry Sandusky costumes
on.
It could have been Halloween.
Yeah.
But that was pretty righteous. You know, they have this fraternity row right by Camp Randall.
Okay.
And me and my buddy, we're just like, let's just fake that we're in these fraternities and go in there. So we just went into random fraternity houses, shotgunned a bunch of beer, and then when they're like, hey, who do you know who's here? We're like,
Jimmy's cousin.
Ron. And then we'd run out.
Is code name for run.
Right? That's really crazy.
Ron!
But I think we ended up getting like 12 beers.
There you go.
To walk in. And so then I don't really remember the rest of the game. But that was a ton of fun. And then I've been to a bunch of Packer tailgates as well. And I feel like that's a vastly different game for tailgating than any other NFL team. So
yeah, that's
it's
true.
More of a college atmosphere there.
Small town sort of feel to it.
That's, the Vikings the same way too. I got a good story.
Even at U.S. Bank?
No, when they had the dome.
The dome, okay.
That was, you're about a block away from the actual dome and you're getting shit-faced drunk. There's plenty of beer pong going on and plenty of food. And good story that I'm not going to tell right now because it'll take way too much time. So I'll save that story for another day.
Okay.
But let's say I had a girlfriend one time, tore her knee. She blew out her MCL and ACL playing beer pong. That's a story I got to tell later.
That sounds like something I need to know.
Before the game. Anyways, I like Vikings tailgating. The Gophers tailgating was... It was okay. We were kind of far away last week for Gophers tailgating, but we still got drunk. I had a shitload of beer, and I still got a shitload of beer.
Okay. So you think about the same NCAA, NFL?
I'm
going to
go
same?
NFL. I think NFL is better.
Okay. What about you?
See, my experiences with tailgating are fairly
minimal.
Minimal.
Yeah.
So I've yet to see an NFL game. I've yet to see a Division I football game. But my experiences at BSU have been great, so I'm going to say that was good. The one thing that I have heard is that NFL tailgating doesn't start until a certain time where you can't go there until like something like 4 hours before.
Okay.
That's what I've heard. There's like an actual rule. But
that's beyond me.
But compared to college football, you can start whenever you want. So
yeah.
If that's a rule in my book, I'm going to have to go with college football.
You know, BSU does have some great tailgating.
They do.
Like, because there have been so many tailgates where it's just been a complete gong show, you know. And but I went to one D1 game or one D1AA game, and that was in Brookings, South Dakota.
Yeah, went go
to,
Jacks!
Yeah, went to South Dakota State. It was for Hobo Days.
Yes,
my buddy went. He graduated from there, and so he brought me back for Hobo Days and.
Touchdown Jesus.
Yeah, we saw Touchdown Jesus, but holy shit. It was there were, I would say, 2.5 times as many people tailgating outside the stadium than actually made it into the game.
That's fantastic. I love that atmosphere.
It was every single place had beer pong and some specialty shot. And we got
a lot of blue, huh?
Couple mystery bottles being passed around.
And like it just people walking around, and it was totally fine. Like it was so much fun to do this, and we got totally obliterated. And I remember we shotgunned our first beer, and I don't shotgun; I like chug because otherwise I throw up.
Go on.
At 8:30 in the morning.
Damn.
Right.
That'll get you going.
The game didn't start until 2. It was insane. I don't know how we made it through that day.
What took you so long to start at 8:30?
Well, we had to drive from Fargo. Oh, of
course. It's only a couple of road beers, though, right?
Yeah, only 3 hours, 3.5.
Oh, and I'm just getting told now that South Dakota State actually changed the rules now.
What?
They said there's no tailgating. You get ID'd, and it's lame.
Oh.
How sad.
That is very sad. Uh-oh, retard alert. I do actually have one experience with tailgating back when I played junior hockey with the Des Moines Buccaneers in Des Moines, Iowa.
Screw
they
Iowa.
Actually
was it in Des Moines?
Yeah, it was in Des Moines.
Oh,
and
fuck me.
And
fuck me.
When the weather actually started to get nice around like March or so, like Iowa, the weather's a little warmer. So people started to tailgate before the games. And I remember one of the players, we were like warming up outside doing our little stretches and dynamic
soccer,
movements, that sort of thing. And one of our players, he was offered a hot dog, and so he downed a hot dog right before the game from one of the the fans. So that was kind of cool.
That's fun. So, but I think the best tailgating I've ever been to was at Lambeau Field, and you just party in people's backyards.
And oh yeah,
I went there with a couple of my buddies. And just chugged a bunch of Spotted Cow, and it was great. We went in the game, and they won. It was cold. Anytime it's cold at Lambeau, it's like the best day ever.
It's better when it's cold.
So I think NFL Lambeau, but overall NCAA, super good. What do you say?
Vikings till pregame.
And for you, BSU?
College football.
Yeah. All right, football. We'll be right back. Burn it down. It's... Beer Belly Sports Podcast at WBLZ.
What up? We're three cool guys looking for other cool guys who want to hang out in our party mansion. Nothing sexual. Dudes in good shape encouraged. If you're fat, you should be able to find humor in the little things.
I have no problem with that.
No, let's go meet some men.
You're listening to Beer Belly Sports.
And he's driven our lives into the ground. When we woke up, we were wasted and drunk. Phil got shot. We got beaten by a monk. I was happy and my life was good. Getting married like a dentist should. Roasting marshmallows on a stick. I got fucked in the ass by a girl with a dick.
I remember that.
And we're living here in Allentown. But they're taking Teddy's finger now. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna lose my shit. Shoot Allen in the face and shoot myself.
You totally butchered that song.
Totally butchered my life.
With all of these different people involved, there's a lot of balls. And this show gets at least three guys deep, so make your own conclusions. Beer Belly Sports.
Welcome back to the Beer Belly Sports Podcast, live from Fozzie Smoke and Barbecue on WBLZ. If you haven't already, download the WBLZ app. It is super easy to listen to all of your favorite WBLZ podcasts, and most especially ours.
Yeah, of course, right?
And so when you're listening to them, you don't even have to have that app open. It'll play in the background, unlike when you're on SoundCloud when you have to have it open.
Also, the WBLZ has a new website. It's WBLZmedia.com.
Right on. Check that out. You can see some bios about us. I absolutely love Mitch's because it is so fucking funny. It's like Geoffrey, the producer, Steve-O, I don't even know.
The host.
And then Mitch, the face, also from Canada.
I figured people like it. A little international.
I've got a great face for radio. So, thanks, guys. Yeah.
You know what? We're doing our best to help out the melting pot that is the world, most especially America, bringing in an immigrant to work on our our podcast.
Genius.
Anyways, check
take that
out.
Donald.
WBLZmedia.com. Download the WBLZ Network app. And yeah, let's get into this. We're talking about whether Ezekiel Elliott deserves to be suspended.
This would be super quick.
Yeah, because I do.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
I'll save mine for last.
See, I say no. Like, if Tom Brady did what he did and he got the full year to postpone the suspension,
yeah,
then Ezekiel Elliott deserves the same thing.
Well, isn't that what they're doing?
Yeah.
Okay, then that's what I mean. Like, I feel like...
Like, you want him to be suspended now or, no, like, later?
Like, later, I think.
Yeah, yeah. I think he deserves something for sure.
The legal process
for sure
goes through and he gets punished by the law.
Yes.
And then his suspension should be based off of what they decide.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, I completely agree.
Cool.
The guy deserves it.
Yeah. What do you say? Be the hot take man.
As a Cowboys fan.
Boo.
Boo this man. Oops, I almost hit the wrong button. I almost said Homer's woohoo.
You should have. That would have made way more sense.
Yeah, but I didn't want to. It would have been
okay.
Bad.
Okay, so anyways, what do you got to say for yourself?
I believe that he should be.
You do?
Yeah, I know.
As a Cowboys fan?
I know. This reason. Yeah, she changed her story. Okay, whatever. That part, you know, should be, you know, you should be let go of and drop charges.
So how did she change this?
I don't know.
Story?
I wasn't listening as normal guy.
Oh, there we go.
But through the grapevine.
Through the grapevine.
She changed her story and the other shit that Zeke has done. Like dancing on top of tables, lifting up women's shirts and some other stupid shit. Mm-hmm. That he shouldn't be doing. So I think it should be 4 games.
Okay.
4 games.
Do you think it should be right now or next year?
Right now is fine.
Wow.
Teach him a lesson.
Yeah. Well,
there you go.
You know what, Geoffrey? I appreciate what you just said because that makes more. I didn't know all that other stuff that was going on.
Yeah,
I just heard about the first one, and now I might change my mind.
Yeah.
I might agree with Geoffrey.
So are the Cowboys 1-1 right now?
Yes.
So you want them to be gone right now just because the season's not going to – they're not going to be good anyway. So
they're 1-1.
Yeah. just write it off, guys.
Oh, that's awful, man.
It's like my fantasy team. Just write them off. Oh, whoa, what are you guys cheering over there for?
High fives over here, apparently.
Were you acing a test?
I've taken this test 63 times.
Holy
and
shit.
I finally passed it.
Oh, wow. Right? Well, persistence.
Nursing school. It's like, a son of a bitch.
God damn.
And it's gone.
Yep. So, cool beans, Barrett.
Yay!
So, we all agree on the Ezekiel Elliott thing.
Yep.
Yeah.
Cool.
Give him the hammer.
Yeah, give him the hammer.
Fuck that guy.
let's move on to something as near and dear to Steve-O.
Literally, like, near to my hometown. I grew up in Appleton, just south of Green Bay.
Yeah.
And I love the Lambeau Field atmosphere. It's very much like a college atmosphere where it's right in the neighborhood.
Oh, yeah?
And you found
a
house.
Fucker.
You found a house right across the street from Lambeau Field that is selling for $1 million.
That's a low price.
Describe this house to me, Geoffrey.
What's
it look like? It's a 1960 colonial.
It's a split level, and there's a nice backyard.
That sounds like
backyard
your old house.
Is Lambeau Field.
Yeah, I mean, that is a very nice.
Your
backyard.
Your backdoor view is the Lambeau Stadium, Lambeau Field Stadium. This house is going for $1 million. It is
ridiculous.
A 2-bedroom house, no backyard.
Mm.
But like I said, you have a very beautiful Lambeau Field.
I don't know what accent that is. Is
I
that
like,
a realtor voice?
The Price is Right guy who talks
over.
Today we have a watch set from
That Swiss? Can be yours for the it, all the way the price is right. Right. Yeah, just like $1 million. That's crazy, and you don't even get a backyard.
Do you know what I think
backyard
should happen?
Field.
I think a really, really rich Viking fan should buy it.
Oh.
Put up a bunch of Viking shit. Oh, that'd
they
be
would
funny.
Get murdered.
Yeah, I'd probably get burned with ground.
Yeah,
that would be. Hilarious.
That would be the
oh,
worst
good
thing ever.
For you.
But
a million
like,
bucks. Like honestly, I'm looking at this house right now. It's a single level. It's got some bricks.
What
it
color
looks,
is it?
It's brown brick with looks like Viking green trim around the windows.
Viking green.
Oh, I'm sorry. Packer green. My yeah. apologies. Oh, it actually has a it's Green actually, Bay Packers mailbox.
Oh, perfect. The Vikings green is just the envy that they have with their neighbors with all the Super Bowls.
The house is a two-bedroom, two-bathroom with a one-stall garage. And the front lawn is pretty small. Nice driveway with garage space and for guest parking. Man, good thing I totally just live read the hell out of that.
Wow.
Reading is never your strong suit.
The neighborhood isn't this quiet on game day. Oh, no shit.
Really? No fucking way.
I would buy that place and turn it into a sweet party atmosphere.
I would take out the wall in between the kitchen and the living room, and I would really I'd put an island in there and really open up the place, you know? It would be a lot of area for you to entertain your friends.
No problem.
I would, like, bye. They should just make it,
if
like,
you're
some beer pong areas, right? Or maybe you just...
I mean, they could, like...
How's the parking at Lambeau?
You know, it's a big parking lot, but is I feel it? Like it'd be really cool to, like, just rent that house out for, like...
Yeah, people who want to come down for the weekend and
right.
stay close
like
to the
Airbnb
oh,
that thing.
Yes, you can make some bank.
I really
although
love
the hefty price of $1 million for the
yeah, but
house.
Do you have $500,000?
Let's go in.
I also don't have $500,000.
Was your wedding $500,000?
So. Excuse me. I was in Bowabic, not Barbados.
Well, there's that.
So, yeah, I think I like if my parents loved me, they would buy me that house.
Oh, they don't.
Well, it looks like you're living in Bemidji.
I guess I'm stuck here.
The rest of your life.
That's funny. So, wow, Lambeau Field. You could totally make your mortgage just by, you know, charging people to park in your driveway or on your front lawn.
Oh, for sure. You can make a pretty penny. Speaking of parents
oh,
and DNA... The Ravens are giving away a free DNA test kit to their fans this weekend.
What?
Yes, this is true. The Baltimore Ravens are giving away DNA test kits that will have the Ravens logo on it.
Is it the Montel Williams sponsored weekend or what?
I have no
I know they're playing in England this weekend. They're
playing, yeah.
They're playing against the Jaguars.
Oh, no. This must have been last weekend then.
Okay.
But
that's
yeah.
so funny.
So I actually did a little bit of research, believe
obviously
it or
not.
And well, this is what I'm saying. So I wanted to tell you guys some of the weirdest promotions, fan promotions that have been out there.
Oh, we need some background music.
You guys ready for this?
Let me get some. Hold on, don't go anywhere.
Okay. Well, I'm sure I could go over a little bit of this. This Ravens.
No time for this preparation.
So I guess perfect. There we go. Okay, so weirdest promotions. The Charleston River Dogs, a Class A affiliate of the Tampa Bay Devil Rays, wanted to set a record no one could break. So they decided on a nobody night, a night where they would padlock the gates and not let a single fan into the game was official.
Yeah. I heard about that game.
And the lowest attendance ever was zero fans.
Oh, my God.
Fans instead were directed to a party tent where they were given discounted beer and food.
That's awesome.
Moving on, we have the Altoona Curve, a AA affiliate of the Pittsburgh Pirates, hosted Awful Night. The promotion aim was to give customers a bad experience.
Oh,
the
God.
First 1,000 fans got a picture of the general manager's gallbladder. And one fan was awarded the general manager's actual gallbladder.
Genius.
So
one lucky
fan. A-plus
yes!
to the,
got what I wanted.
To the Altoona Curve.
That's funny.
The Hudson Valley Renegades decided on a promotion that gave away a toilet seat to the first 3,000 fans.
Wow.
The Jeez. Promotion was a follow-up to a plunger given away from the previous year by the same team.
Oh, that's great.
Good job, man.
Fans of the Cleveland
Cleveland Indians, not idiots, nice. Were encouraged to drink as many 10-cent 8-ounce beers as possible.
Genius.
When was this?
Wasn't I invited?
I think it was back in the 70s. It says, obviously before drunk driving was taken seriously.
Oh. Well, did they do that at the... anyway, sorry.
Well, fans complied with the idea, and the result was a bunch of drunken baseball fans. To summarize what happened that night, high tensions led to a riot at the point that many fans... that many felt the Texas Rangers players and coaches' lives may be actually at risk, and the Indians were forced to forfeit.
Damn.
So this promotion gave the Indians a loss.
I used to work at a baseball stadium, the Wisconsin Timber Rattlers, and affiliate of the – used to be the Mariners, but now the Brewers. And they used to have dollar beer night every Tuesday.
Yes. Nice.
Literally every Tuesday. And so they'd have dollar beer night, and then – sometimes Sara Lee would also sponsor it. So then you'd go in, get as many beers as you wanted for like a dollar each. And then on the way out, you'd get handed a loaf of bread.
And I used to sober
work
up.
Right. I used to work in the parking lot. So people, like, we'd have bachelor parties show up to that and then buses, and you'd just get pelted with bread balls.
Damn.
Want some bread? Okay, last one. The Charleston River Dogs, where the. Part of their promotion was to give away G-strings to select fans. So
like
there
that.
You go. There's a couple weird promotions for you guys.
Right on. We're going to take a quick break and dive more into the world of sport. And
I got a game, too.
You got a game? Okay,
we
good.
We got Caner's game.
Like normal. And
and misconnections.
Yes, that too.
That's all coming up in the Beer Belly Sports Podcast on WBLZ from Fozzie Smoking Barbecue.
You drunk?
No. But this ought to do it.
I would fire you. If you weren't so goddamn beautiful out there. You smell like urine.
The semi-pro of sports radio, Beer Belly Sports.
What's up, everybody? I'm Dizzy.
And I'm John.
And you can catch us every Saturday and Sunday from 1 to 2 p.m. on the Weekend Sports Podcast, only on WBLZ Sports.
We've got balls.
And yeah, you can catch us on our SoundCloud and iTunes page as well, the Weekend Sports Podcast. But who cares? I'm asking you guys to catch us from 1 to 2 p.m. Saturday and Sundays on WBLZ Sports.
Because we've got balls.
Gen Service offers complete electrical service with a reputation based on quality. Turn to them for residential, commercial, and industrial electrical service. Doesn't matter if it's new construction, homes, electrical panels, hot tubs, generators, or a commercial rewire. The Gen Service team is licensed, bonded, and insured to put your electrical concerns at ease. For an electrical contractor with 25 years of service, give Gen Service a call at 740-438-7173.
I'm so tired of so-called prophets giving me terrible fantasy football advice.
I'm tired of these corn-fed cousin kissers on the four-letter network trying to steer my goddamn team into the wall.
And I'm tired of juiced-up, washed-up linebackers trying to pretend like they know fantasy football. Gentlemen, that is exactly why we created Pony Keg Sports, your number one place to go for fantasy football sports every Tuesday night on WBLZ. We got balls, baby. Woo!
What's up, sports fans? This is Denton Day from In My Opinion with Denton Day. Do you love hard-hitting opinions mixed with a slightly above-average sense of humor?
And he taps me on the back and he says, look, there's Yao Ming over there. Look at his legs. His calves were as big as my 10-year-old head.
If you do, be sure to check out my show, In My Opinion with Denton Day, live every Monday from 8 to 9 p.m. only on WBLZ Sports. We've got balls.
Doug Pepford Painting and Pressure Wash. He has over 30 years of painting experience. He's interior, exterior, commercial, or residential. Doug Pepford covers it all. Is your house looking ugh? Well, call on Doug. Doug Pepford Painting and Pressure Washing, 404-966-3361. Mention WBLZ Sports and get a special We've Got Balls discount. That's Doug Pepford Painting and Pressure Washing, 404-966-3361.
WBLZ Sports, we've got balls, there's the sponsors, your balls.
Beer Belly Sports at Fozzie's, home of the best barbecue in Bemidji, probably northern Minnesota, southern Canada, and hell, it's pretty damn good. Here's Steve-O, Geoffrey, and Caner.
All right. Well, welcome back to the Beer Belly Sports Podcast, live from Fozzie's Smoke and Barbecue.
Ew.
On the WBLZ Network. And we've got Caner's game.
Yeah. You guys ready for this?
I think so.
Okay. So, if you guys haven't heard this week, Kevin Durant got into a little bit of trouble.
Oh, yeah. Some burner accounts.
Yeah. So, he started his own, he's got a little side account, and he was tweeting, I guess he's been using this account to tweet some good things about himself and tweet some bad things about his teammates and his coaches and his organization when he was part of Oklahoma. Anyways, it looks like he accidentally tweeted from his actual official Kevin Durant account saying, and I quote, "He didn't like the organization or playing for Billy Donovan. His roster wasn't that good. It was just him and Russ." So this was coming from his actual account. And
yeah.
So that kind of triggered.
Stuck it in the third person.
Yeah, yeah. There you go. So that will influence our game today, which I would like to call Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey, in which I will read a quote, and these two guys will guess if it is Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey.
All right. Do I go first or do you go first?
You can.
I'll go first.
Okay.
Do you want to recap the...
Yes, give us the scores, please.
Okay. I should probably start the song over.
Yeah, whatever.
It's all right.
Let's loop it real quick. There we go. But as it loads up, reminder, thanks to everybody listening on WBLZ. And we are on, is it 5 Eastern?
I have no idea. You're the one in charge of that.
4 p.m. Central on Sundays.
There we go.
Oh, is that what you? Because you get the Twitter about it.
Yeah, well, and I typically go to work at 5 p.m. and usually like an hour before it starts.
Oh, so 4 p.m. Central time.
Because I actually listen to our show.
Oh, I listen to our show. You fuckers didn't know that we'd left the mic check in.
Yeah, I did. I heard it. Mean. I thought it was on purpose.
No.
I thought it was, too.
It was kind of funny.
Because it was hilarious.
Yeah, I loved it.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
Winners. Let's see. I am 4-13-2. Steve-O in a bombing 13-5-2. Struthers is 1-0.
That a boy, Struts. Okay, our first quote of the day. I'm aware that from the outside, this looks like I've got an ego. I've got quite an ego. I'm aware that from the outside, this looks like I've got quite an ego. Is that Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey?
I'm going to go with Kevin Durant.
I'll go Kevin Spacey.
That is Kevin Spacey.
Yeah. Finally on the board.
1-0 gift.
This is not how I don't get Fredberg
often. This is weird. I don't know what to do.
Let's go. Next quote. I just want to grow spiritually with the Lord. I'm keeping strong at it. Just trying to make my walk with the faith a little better. Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey?
Jeffrey has to go first.
I'm going to go Kevin Spacey.
No.
Steve-O?
Nah, I'm going to go Durant.
That is Kevin Durant.
Damn. There's a space.
Did you start to celebrate as I said Kevin?
I was going to go.
half right. We half points.
I got the first name right.
Yeah, is that a good count?
I don't understand how this game works anyways.
Next quote. So one point apiece.
Okay.
Yay.
Okay. When people are used to doing something, they want you to stay in that lane. When people are used to you doing something, they want you to stay in that lane.
That sounds really intelligent. I want to go Kevin. God, this seems like a trick question. Mitch usually tells a trick question.
I know. I'm going to go with Kevin Spacey.
I think Kevin Spacey as well, too.
That is Kevin Durant.
No fucking way.
Yeah. When people are used to you doing something, they want you to stay. What are you saying? He's dumb?
I don't know.
Well, he was kind of dumb with the Twitter, but yeah.
So there's that.
Okay. So, no points. Next quote. My life will change because I want it to change. My life will change because I want it to change. Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey?
Durant.
Durant and Steve.
Tarantula.
I'm going to go with Spacey.
That is Kevin Spacey.
Damn it, yes. Mother...
2-1 Steve-O.
It's not like any of these pre-ones matter.
Three left.
Jesus.
Okay, next quote.
For me, coming to work every day has turned out to be exactly what I would hope it to be. Is that Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey?
It's your turn.
I know. I'm going to go with Durant. Wait. Yeah. Dumbass.
Geoffrey?
Spacey.
That is Kevin Spacey.
Tie. 2-2.
2-2. 2-2. Two left.
Let's go.
2-2. Next quote.
Well, don't do that again. That was horrible.
I'm sorry.
People probably thought, yeah. That's what it seemed
like. Nervousness.
So much anticipation.
There is.
Next quote. With everything I do, I just try to be myself. With everything I do, I just try to be myself. Is that Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey? Geoffrey?
Durantula.
You going with Durant?
What?
Durantula. He's long armed.
I'm going to go with Spacey because the world's going to end.
I wanted another one. I'm sorry. I got 15 in my account, so.
There you have it. Well,
sick break, dude.
So can we recap our answers here? That was
I had Spacey.
So Steve-O had Spacey and Geoffrey had Durant, right?
Durantula.
Okay. That is Kevin Durant.
Yeah, I'm ahead.
3-2, Geoffrey. Last quote worth 14,000 points.
I'm gonna
points don't matter.
The quote reads a little something like this.
Okay. Come on, I need this. Otherwise, I want to go home and kill myself.
Jesus.
Not really, just figuratively.
Okay, here we go. I like something simple and traditional. I like dinner and a movie. The best way to get someone is to have a conversation over dinner. Is that Kevin Durant or Kevin Spacey?
Is it your turn or my turn?
We count at the same time.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
Same time. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Kevin
go.
Spacey.
Spacey. Both of you guys going Spacey. Well, this is...
It doesn't matter.
Kevin Durant.
I still won. I don't give a shit.
There you have Woo-hoo. It. Geoffrey with the win.
Off the schneid.
Bump him up to
I'm going
five
to
wins.
5-13 now. Let's go. Man,
I don't even remember what it's like to have only five wins.
Shut
so long.
Probably back.
Yeah, that was like episode 5.
By the way, this is our 30th episode.
Oh my 30th God. Episode. Holy shit.
Do you remember when we first started?
I do. In my basement.
That means we're like a third dead.
Oh.
What?
Well, average life expectancy is like 89 or something. So
oh,
that's what I was getting.
That's how many episodes you're talking?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I could be done with.
Just kidding. We're going to go forever. We're never leaving.
Well,
ever. So, congratulations, Geoffrey. I hope you're happy.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well deserved.
About time.
I suppose.
I needed a win.
All right. We will be back with more of the Beer Belly Sports Podcast on WBLZ, live from Fozzie's.
It's the best dream I've ever had! Everybody pee on the floor! Who's with me?
You're listening to Beer Belly Sports. Find us on Twitter, BBS_podcast. More from Fozzie Smoke and Barbecue after this.
OMG. What the hell happened on the last episode of Beer Belly Sports?
Is all you have to say to make it real that you would have to say that you love me, 'cause I already know what you do.
All right, enough of that. There we go.
That was awesome.
That's a little...
So, there was that. Beer Belly Sports Podcast.
Hello, is it me you're looking for?
I wrote our names a thousand times just to see your city next to mine.
She's been running through my dreams, and it's driving me crazy, it seems.
I see you in everything.
I can't go there.
It's too much of
I can't go there.
Welcome back to Beer Belly Sports. It's time now for Missed Connections with Steve. Oh.
Welcome back, folks. We've got some good ones today. A lot of short ones, but just as long as...
Just how Jeffrey's fiance likes them.
Short and very short.
Short and short.
I may not be all that long, but I sure am skinny.
All no, right. I have good girth.
We don't care.
You asked, kind of. I'm more distant. You just weren't.
No, we
can
just
I
told.
Do my misconnections,
yeah,
or do
go
we
for
just
it,
want
whatever.
To talk about what's going on with you?
No, go for it.
Are you sure?
Sure. It's all about you. You're the host.
easy producer.
I think we're going to have to throw down after this.
No, you're bigger.
All right. Well, as long as that's settled. This one's titled Looking for Christy from Black Duck.
Looking.
That's actually the first sentence, too.
Whoa.
Looking for Christy from Black Duck. Used to trim your horses. Lost your contact number. Please respond with my name. Derp. Okay.
All right.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. This one's titled Walmart. And it's not the way you think it's going to be. It's a woman looking for a man from Walmart.
Hell yeah.
All right. Maybe I go there 2 times a day.
I think this one might be about you.
I like this.
When I walked in, I saw you in the produce section. You let me buy, and I said thank you. Then I was behind you and your son in the checkout lane.
Nope.
And you moved your stuff so I could put mine on the belt. You have a tattoo on your right arm. Tell me what it is so I know it's you. If you have a NSA meets or kick, tell me the name you go by.
Okay.
I think I read that one before.
I don't think so.
It was much better this time.
Thanks. This one's Brandon. Woman looking for man. There's not a moment that goes by that I think of you. Plenty of times that I've seen your truck. Just waved to see if you knew it was me. I'm so sorry how things went, and I would really like to be able to, maybe one day, be your friend again.
Be it.
Even though I don't deserve that, as you are such an incredible man and father, and just all around amazing. If you by some chance read this, please respond. Just so I actually know it's you. Please tell me something in the message about our first meeting.
Your eyes.
Ooh, Brandon.
Your move, Brandon.
The ball is in your proverbial court. And our final one. Miss my dream girl. Would love to hear from you. We haven't talked now for some time. We used to talk every day. You were the only family I had. I made some mistakes, but I've changed a lot over the last few months. I would like to talk to you and tell you what has changed since we last spoke. Your Boy Scout is still here, single, and would do anything to fix things.
Am okay.
Well done. Well done.
Go. Good job, Steve.
Thanks. Oh, I got one more.
Oh, you find one?
Bonus. Bonus round.
We
bumped into one another at the store. Man looking for woman. Luke and South.
Ooh.
Another produce section find.
Find everybody's produce, I guess.
You stare at those cucumbers long enough, you know.
Right? You're bound to get aroused and touch.
You find those melons.
Those eggplants. Just call my name.
Sure they do.
I saw you in the store in the produce aisle, and again in the fresh meat area. You are very attractive, about 5'7". Awesome dark hair and great figure. We checked out at the same time, and you went to your car before I. You were parked on the end of the road next to the store. I happened to be parked next to you. You were driving a two-door Honda.
Nope.
And I was driving my Chevy truck. You looked over at me, and I feel there was an attraction between us. You left the parking lot to the north. I was so caught off guard, and stopped to stop you to say hi. If you read this, tell me the color of your car and my truck. I felt like a deer in the headlights and didn't know which way to jump. The date was August 15th.
So long.
At about 5:30 p.m.
So, yeah, there you go.
So there's our misconnections. Didn't have a lot of longing this weekend, but I have a feeling that we're going to have some more after this weekend.
Speaking of deer in the headlights, I hit a deer this week.
What?
Yeah.
Mitchell, you murderer.
It was scary.
I hit a deer, too.
What'd you do to this weekend?
This was Monday as I was coming home from work at like 2 in the morning.
Mm-hmm. I
closed down the bar. And I was just getting onto the highway, onto Highway 2. And this little bastard just comes sprinting up the hill and jumps right out from left to right. And
them
just,
bastards.
I just clipped him, but he cracked my bumper. I don't know if he's alive or dead, but Mr. Deer, I'm sorry. Don't be stupid next time.
Next
time I'm going to finish you, motherfucker.
I had a deer hit
Rats
me.
With hooves. Rats with hooves.
That's right.
I had a deer hit me right in the side in my of my Kia.
You're oblique? Oh.
No, not that.
It jumped in the car.
As I was playing baseball, this deer came
out of nowhere.
Weirdest thing I'd ever seen.
No, I was.
It mounted me from behind.
And then things happened.
They said let him finish, but I didn't know.
Little do we know, there's another little Geoffrey runner.
Geoffrey with hooves.
That hairy bastard.
Oh, bastards.
Literally.
Literally.
Fuckers.
Oh, that might be the worst way to end any show that we've ever had. What did we learn today?
That Mitch really, really loves Tom Brady. I think he has a hard on.
Yeah, good job, Tom. Keep it up, bud.
After that week, I'm surprised.
Will you marry me, Tom?
Well, it's about damn time.
You had one bad week.
Well, I expected more.
You know what I learned? I learned that an easy W is if you play anyone in the Geoffrey clan.
Oh, yeah.
They seem like awful,
damn,
awful fantasy football players.
They're just weaker.
I hate all of them.
They're weak-minded. They're weak-spirited. They're just bad.
What happened for me, I lost the first week to a Geoffrey. I said to myself, you know what?
Never again.
Never again.
No.
Never.
You know what? I'm proud of you.
Thanks.
You stood up for what you believed in.
Assholes.
Resilient. The Canes took it to them.
My God, I can't believe it.
Oh, my God, I got to be Cain.
I learned today that we all agree about Ezekiel Elliott, which is crazy. Yeah. I didn't know we'd all agree about that. Sure we'd all, not agree on that.
No, he
should fuck off.
He should.
Wow.
I think Kevin Durant needs to put his phone away.
I think so, too.
Yeah. Stop being so petty.
I think Kevin Spacey needs to have more diverse quotes that can't be confused with a basketball
this
player.
This is the thing. He does, but I took the most vague ones because I
want
to make
it
fun for you.
Because you're a bastard.
Yeah, I'm a bastard.
And I won!
Yeah.
Hooray!
Good for you.
I did. Whatever, man.
Stat-wise, I should have won a long time ago.
Any final thoughts for today, Geoffrey?
No, not really. Let's... thanks, everybody, for listening to WBLZ. Go to the media, WBLZmedia.com. It's where a lot of our stuff broadcasted. Check out our page, Beer Belly Sports, Facebook page, Twitter, all that good stuff. BBS_podcast is our Twitter. Mitch runs that.
Hell yeah.
I run the old Facebook page because I like to have fun.
And I occasionally do one of each of those things. Kaner, what are your final thoughts for today?
We got balls.
We got balls. All right. Don't forget to download the WBLZ Network app. My name's Steve L. That's Geoffrey.
Bye.
Kaner.
Love you, Canada.
We'll be back next week.
Bye. Have a good weekend.
Deadbeat Packer fans. Suck butt ass white monkey dick. Call me back, man. It's Conrad.
You know, I really like that.
Yep, me too.
Are we in the right theater?